Welcome back, folks. Thanks for clicking on my video as always. Y'all know that I like mouse guns. Well, let me introduce you to the mouse's mouse gun. Are you ready? It's not in there. You know why? Because it won't fit in this. Hate to disappoint you, but this is what we're looking at. This is the North American Arms 22 short. Trying to get good focus on that for y'all. Can't do it. You can really see the reflections from my LED lighting overhead on this, but yeah, I just want to take a quick look at this today. I do plan on doing a video that will do nothing but a bunch of size comparisons of this revolver. But I'm going to do a few little quick ones today and just going over it just to mainly focus on it. But a lot of people are very interested in the size of this weapon. And let me just show you right now. We are empty. You can see that the cylinders are empty in it, okay? So, and yes, I do know it's not in the safety notch because it's not loaded. But people like this gun. Now, what practical purposes it has? Not much beyond a novelty. Now, with that said, I'm not above carrying this. Definitely not as a primary, but I actually ordered a small neck holster for this, which I've carried. I've neck carried some NAAs before. But they're a little heavy for net carry, so I'm going to try this one, this little short one, and just see, you know, hey, just see how it works out. So as far as net carry. Now, there are some YouTube videos out there that have chronographed these with different types of 22 short ammo. And I think some of them get 700 to 800 feet per second out of these. And yeah, that's not bad, folks. You know, as Hickok 45 would say, it's still a bullet and nobody wants to get hit with it. And I will say, too, I have seen these shot before. Not this one. This one has never been shot, to my knowledge, outside of NAA. This is a brand new one. But these little puppies are loud. So if you fire off one or two rounds from this thing in a situation, they hear that going off, I'm sure a bad guy is just going to know, this guy's got a gun. He's trying to stop the threat. I'm out of here. The question a lot of people ask, will it fit an Altoids 10? Well, let me tell you, almost. Let me just show you right here. I don't know if any, maybe this is the first on YouTube, but yeah, almost fit, you know, but it's just quite won't make it. Just quite won't make it. Even if it had smaller grips, you can see actually that the bird's head portion doesn't allow it to sit down in there. Now, maybe someone could, I really don't know how you could even get this in here. Just won't go. Now, I have seen people erroneously say that it would fit in an Altoids 10, so that's why I wanted to introduce that in this video and say, hey, mine will not. But those who don't know what we're looking at, this is a 22 short revolver, which means it will only shoot 22 shorts. So what are 22 shorts? Let me show you. Boom. Okay, well, I've got these laid out here, and as soon as I start touching them, they're going to start rolling, but this is a 22 short, and let me try to get this in frame just a little bit better for you. Yeah, there they go, rolling. 22 short. Let's just do this like this, folks. This is the 22 long rifle, which most of us are familiar with. The 22 short is the same diameter of cartridge, but you can see that the length is obviously shorter. Now, can you guess why they call it the 22 short? Right, yeah. Now, does anybody, or is anybody an old fart like me, do you remember before they had 22 long rifle, they had 22 longs? Well, the 22 longs were in between the shorts and the long rifles. And I can't tell you the last time I even saw 22 longs on the shelf. I'm sure you can probably still order them or buy them or something like that. But nowadays, just predominantly 22 long rifle, but you can go out and buy 22 shorts. As a matter of fact, I think I might be wrong on this, but I would probably call this the smallest firearm you can get that uses readily available ammunition. As in, you can go to Academy, Bass Pro, Gander Mountain. Well, Gander Mountain's closed down. Cabela's, places like that, and probably find you some 22 long rifle ammunition. You can most definitely go online and order some if you can't find any. Now, I know they make some fancy little guns that use these real small calibers that are smaller than this one. But again, I'm talking about readily available for the average Joe. So yeah, we've got 22 short, 22 long rifle for size comparison. This is a 22 Magnum. Now, a lot of you don't know this, but on a 22 Magnum, the bullet diameter is the same diameter as 22, but the case itself is actually very slightly larger diameter on the 22 Magnums. That's why the 22 Magnum, being able to hold this much more powder, is actually a very viable round in long guns, especially like 22 Magnum bolt action, lever action rifles. The 22 Magnum is nothing to be sneezed at. Very viable round. Here we have a 9mm for comparison purposes to the short. And I should have thought this out better, but you know what? I'm a hillbilly, who cares? 9mm compared to 22 short. You can see it's obviously much smaller, and then we'll finish it with a 357 Magnum comparison. So, if you don't know, that's what a 22 short is. Now, back to this. Now, I'm going to show you how this thing loads and unloads, because if you're not familiar with these, you may have never seen this before. But to me, this is just my opinion. To properly learn how to load this and unload it, consult the user manual that's available from North American Arms. Ships with every gun new. If you don't have it, you can call them and they'll send you one for free, I'm sure. You put it in half cock, like so. Pull out the cylinder retaining pin, like so. The cylinder will just fall right out. And you can see it holds 5 little rounds of 22 shorts. You drop your ammo in. Of course, I'm not going to do that here on video. You put your pin back in, make sure everything is lined up. And then you take this and you put it down in a safety notch right between the cylinders. So that makes this firearm safe to carry fully loaded, because as you can see, there will be a round here and there will be a round here. There will not be a round underneath the hammer, because the hammer is located in a safety notch. So there is very, very little chance of this thing going off if you drop it. But that's it, folks. The NAA 22 short. This is going to be a fun little gun, I think, just to tinker around with and shoot and plink on the range. Oh, I didn't give you my sight picture. There you go. There's not even really a groove that you look down. It's just a bladed front sight. Now, real quick, again, I'm going to do a video that has nothing but size comparisons of this gun, along with the other mouse guns, just for reference, for people's reference. But I want to show you just a couple things. A lot of people don't realize how small this actually is. I wear a size medium gloves in, like, mechanics gloves. And you can see that my palm will completely hide that. But let's look at its older brother. This is a North American Arms Pug in 22 Magnum. And you thought it was small. Well, look at this little baby next to it. Right? Real quick again, how about a Ruger LCP2? This is my preferred carry when I leave the house. Tiny. Let's look at one more and then I will close this video down. Smith & Wesson 642 classic air weight. Tiny. I can't get her to stay there, but ooh, there we go. That's a pretty picture. Tiny. Very small. And just for the heck of it, you know what? Let's go ahead and see what this little puppy weighs. the scale, tear it with 500 grams, 17.6 ounces. Put this up here. 4.2 ounces, right? We'll put one. I only have one short out here. We'll put a short on here and see how much it increases it. 4.3 ounces. So fully loaded, if my math is correct, that would be 4.7 ounces for a five-shot fully loaded firearm. Y'all, that's pretty dang. That's pretty dang light. So, let me know what y'all think. If you have any questions on this little gem, don't hesitate to ask. And as always, please take that time, write that comment, click that thumbs up button. That's really important for us YouTubers. And subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I try to put out all different types of videos. You'll see I do review a lot of guns, a lot of handguns, but I also have some other videos on EDC stuff, camping, outdoor, prepper stuff, things like that. Thanks for watching. Y'all be safe out there.